Hello and welcome to the C3 Kids Studio, where this month we're learning all about how to drop the act. I'm your host, Lisa. How about this week's mask? Isn't it a beauty? I love dressing up and wearing fancy clothes, and I really love wearing costumes where I'm in disguise. You know, where no one knows it's me. It's fun to pretend and use my imagination. I can be anything I want when I do that. But that's not so cool when I'm trying to be someone I'm not in real life. You know what I mean. Like when I'm trying to impress my friends by pretending to be better at something than I really am, or maybe not being completely truthful about something because I'm afraid of what someone might think. God wants us to be truthful and to be okay with who He created us to be. And that's why this month we're focusing on the life app of integrity, choosing to be truthful in whatever you say and do. Yep, it's all about following God and being the real you, wherever you are. Like it says in our memory verse for this month from Proverbs 10:9, anyone who lives without blame will walk safely, but anyone who takes a crooked path will get caught. God can help us live truthfully, and when we do that, we can stay close to Him. Now, I know we're focusing on being truthful, but like I said earlier, it's also fun to wear a costume and even dress up and pretend to be someone we're not from time to time, right? So in the spirit of that, let's get to this week's episode of The Masked Leader, where one of our C3 Kids leaders will don a mask and join us here in the C3 Kids studio. It's your job to figure out who's behind the mask. Are you ready? Let's meet this week's contestant. It's the horse. Love it. All right. Here we have it. One of our C3 Kids leaders dressed as the horse. But do you know who is really behind that mask? In just a moment, we'll ask them to drop the act. But first, let's see if you can figure out who it is. Listen in to these clues.
I have not combed my hair in 20 years. I am the only man in my household, and I have the most dedicated, beautiful, hardworking wife in all of America.
All right, do you think you know who it is? Why don't we find out? Help me at home by shouting along. Are you ready? Here we go. Drop the act! Drop the act! Drop the act! Drop the act!
Yeah! It's hot under there.
Well, as you can see, it's my husband, John. Welcome back to the C3 Kids Studio.
Great to be here.
Good to awesome. Have you here. Awesome.
I always wanted to be a horse.
Yeah, I know you love horses.
I do. That's I love awesome. Horses.
It's a perfect Usually costume for you.
Do
perfect
other things with mask. Horses other than wear their heads, but that's okay.
Well, the fun has just started because we have an awesome game that we're about to play. Are you up for it?
Great. Let's go.
All
I'm
right.
ready.
Let's do it. All right, John. So we're going to play a game, and we've got this table here. And I'm going to get a box. It's called What's in the Box. Have you ever played this game before?
I have never played this game before.
Okay, so I'm going to get a box, and the kids are going to be able to see what's in the box. But you aren't going to be able to, because you're going to be standing right here. And then you're going to have to reach into the box. There'll be a little compartment, a little opening for you to put your hand in, and touch what's in there. And by touching it and feeling it, you have to determine what it is, okay?
Not a big fan of touching things that I can't see.
Don't worry. It'll be fine. Let's go ahead and get the box.
Okay.
Here we go. All right. Can you guys see what it is? I can see what it is. It should be fun.
Does that mean I can
I'm
start?
Sorry. I'm sorry. Whenever you're ready,
okay.
Go ahead and put your hand right in there, and you'll be able to see and feel.
Oh my gosh, it feels like a rubber glove of some sort.
Oh, wow.
It's a rubber glove. Is it a rubber glove? Is it a rubber glove?
It is a rubber glove.
Take wow.
You got
that
it.
That is so awesome.
On the first, like, second of feeling that. Very well
All right,
done.
Cool.
Well done. All right, that was very impressive. Now it's my turn. I wonder if I'll be able to tell as quickly as you did.
Okay.
Get the
okay.
box for me.
Let me get your box.
You know, every week I get a little nervous about this. Every week. This
hold
is
on, hold
second
on, hold
week.
On, hold on. It,
oh.
Hold on.
Oh, I don't like that
okay,
you're
hold on.
Doing it like that. What is in there?
All right. All right.
You know,
hold on,
I
let me
don't
make
like
sure.
to do
Okay,
this.
Are you ready?
Uh-huh.
Oh, hold on. Let me make sure.
Hey.
Hold on. Hold on. Let me make sure his head's in the right direction.
Oh, get out of here. Nuh-uh. Okay. It better not be something alive. I'm kind of scared here. Okay.
Almost. Almost.
Oh, Oh, what is it? Is it Jell-O? I don't know. It's gross. It's gross, and it's all over my fingers.
You got to dig deep.
What is it?
You got to go deeper.
No, like
you got to go all the way in.
In there, I've got it. I've got it. I think it's Jell-O or pudding or something. I don't know.
Close enough.
What is it?
Congratulations! It is chocolate syrup.
Oh,
your favorite.
But I do
usually
like chocolate syrup.
Not
actually
on your fingers.
Yeah, it felt really gross, but that was fun. Well, that was an awesome game. That was a lot of fun.
It was.
Yeah. And the fun is not over because we have another game to play.
But this, another game?
Yes. You like
two games,
though, right?
I like games.
Yeah. And this one actually involves one of our 45 friends. As a matter of fact, they're going to play. Have you ever played Two Truths and a Lie?
I think I've seen it before. I don't think I've ever played it.
Okay. Well, one of our friends in 45 is going to give us two things about them that are true.
Okay.
And one that isn't true. A lie. False. Whatever you want to call it. And then you and I have to determine which one is true, which two are true, and which one is false. Okay?
Okay, I'm ready.
Which one's the lie, basically.
Okay.
Okay.
I think I got it.
Let's listen in.
Hello, my name's Ethan, and I'm in fifth grade. Here are three things about me. Math is my favorite subject. I don't like mac and cheese. And my favorite basketball team is the Golden State Warriors. Can you guess which is a lie?
I think I might have a clue here.
Okay.
Because I think I know this gentleman a little bit.
All right.
I think I might have a clue.
All right. What do you think?
I think it's that math is his favorite subject.
You think that's the lie?
I think that's the lie.
Okay.
Correct.
I was going to say the thing about the mac and cheese. So let's find out.
Okey-doke.
Hi, me again. Did you guess the lie? The lie was that math is my favorite subject.
All right, I'm a winner. All right, good job, Johnny Mo.
I know you love to win, so congratulations. I guessed wrong. I guessed the mac and cheese. But
it's just as much fun
math
to play.
Yeah, it is. It is. And the best part is we got to know a little bit more about Ethan. So thanks, Ethan, for sharing and telling us a little bit more about who you really are. All right, well, the So-and-So Show is on its way in just a moment. But before we get to it, you know at the end of the So-and-So Show, they always reveal the key question.
Reveal right? The question.
That's right.
I remember
you.
That.
That's right. So I was wondering if I could ask you the key question, and maybe you could answer and let everybody know a little bit more about you.
Sure.
Okay. So this week, the key question is, what do you talk to God about?
Wow, I talk to God about a lot of things, but I would say I more often like kind of ask God for guidance. You just typically ask him for stuff. And mostly what I ask him for, though, is the good stuff. Like, I always ask him to take care of our daughters and to make sure they're being guided directly. And I think the thing I ask God most for, though, is health. Mental health, physical health. Mm-hmm. And I ask him often.
That's awesome.
Never get tired of asking.
Well, you guys are going to hear a lot more about that in the So-and-So Show today. You're going to hear about all the things that you can ask God about. And you'll have that conversation, hopefully, with the people that you live with. And your countdown's coming, but we have a little tradition where we like to kind of dance it out here at the end of the Masked Leader. So yeah, if you could become the horse and we can have a dance party.
All right, ready.
We'll see you guys next week.
Ready?
Well, hello everybody. It is so wonderful to see everybody one more time, even if it is right here on camera. I think you should get up and stand up on your feet because it is time to give God some worship. How about we sing, I think, one of your favorites, and it's called Epic Love. And this song talks about how big and strong our God is and how there's no bigger, greater love than the love that God has for us because his love is super epic. So I'm going to teach you the moves for Epic Love. So it starts off with a clap. And then we say, our God is stronger than ever. And then we're gonna say, his love will last, the love he has for me will last forever. We put our hands up and get our roll on, and we're not leaving anybody behind. Now here's the fun part. We're gonna jump up, slide, and let me see how epic God's love is that blows your mind. And we jump again, we slide, and then we just go mind-blowing epic love that God has for us. I can't wait to see you jump and sing. So come on and worship with me.
the light. No one greater than our God above. Shout it out, getting louder now. This kind of light, this kind of love. If you want it, put your hands up, hands up. There's no one greater than our God above. Shout it out, shout it out.
This love is epic, this love is epic. This love is unbelievable, it's blowing my mind. This love is epic,
this love is epic.
This love is epic.
It's on. Oh.
Hello, my name is Brendan, and this is the So-and-So Show, because I'm so smart and so cool. Watch me do the robot. Oh. Thank you. But seriously, I can't do the show without John. He's the best co-host I could ask for. John may be the best co-host out of all the co-hosts in the country. Nay, the universe. It should be the John and John Show. You should definitely tell John how awesome he is next time you see him, maybe in a tweet or a positively worded social media post. Hashtag John is the grooviest. John? What are you doing? Nothing. Are you wearing the mask of me again? What mask? Hand it over. Come on, just a little more fun. No, it's confusing. Hand it over. Fine.
Here.
Thank you.
What happens when I put this on?
No. No. Brandon!
Don't! How do I look? Hello, everyone. My name is Brandon.
And I'm John.
And this is the So-and-So Show. What was that?
Don't worry about it. It's this. Got a phantom.
A phantom?
Yeah, you know, like the musical, the Phantom of the Opera, where there's a guy in a mask that wreaks havoc all over a Paris opera house. It's like that, but.
But here.
Yeah.
Huh.
He's the phantom of my basement.
It's
really annoying.
Why is he here?
Please don't ask that.
Oh, you will know, John. You will know very soon why I am here.
I hired an exterminator, but... Okay, we get it.
Should we invite him on? You know, maybe as someone who knows stuff?
No, don't encourage him. He'll just try to take over.
You can't stop me from taking over, John.
Just ignore him. What are we gonna do today?
I thought that we could play a game.
Okay.
I thought that we could pretend that we were sheep, right? And then one of us could... I'm sorry, I don't think I can ignore this. It's just too distracting. John, you've got to do something about that.
It's actually not that bad once you get used to it.
Hello, fellas.
Oh, hello, Sylvia.
How are things today?
Oh, just fine, thank you. How are things with you?
Oh, same old, same old. Just trying to keep things clean. Wouldn't want things to get messy.
Yeah, wouldn't want that.
Oh, well, I guess I'll be leaving now. To do my job. Nothing mysterious.
Okay, see you, Silvio. That guy.
Who is that, John?
That's Silvio. That's my basement's custodian.
Oh, really? Yeah. I didn't know your basement had a custodian.
But you don't think this place keeps its shining glory all by itself, do you?
He's clearly the Phantom, though, right?
What? No. No. The Phantom wears a mask.
All right.
Silvio doesn't wear a mask.
Yeah, but has he been here as long as the Phantom has?
Yes.
Does he say creepy things and stare off into the distance all the time?
Yes, of course, but all custodians do that.
Here's a picture of Silvio.
All right.
And now...
I left the stove on. Oh, whew. Almost burned my Skettios. Oh, hey, it's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Kellen.
Hey, Kellen.
Hello, Kellen.
What was that?
Phantom?
Huh. Maybe you could talk in private. I'll call you. Will this work?
Sure.
Why not?
I just want to make one adjustment.
Whoa, Kellen, what happened? You look shiny.
Well, that's a filter. Those are the buttons at the bottom of the screen. People use them for social media all the time. Filters make us look better than we feel.
Well, they can also do this.
Whoa, whoa. Ah. Do you guys smell something in here?
Woo. All right, here, I'm gonna try it here. Hold on. Oh, look at me, I'm so studious. Bum, 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 bum.
Bah, 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 bah.
Okay, I think I've lost control here. Alright, filters off.
Oh.
Yeah, like I was saying, filters make you look better than you actually are. Here, I can look cool.
Sir.
Or I can be rich and famous.
Hello, I'm rich and famous.
Or you don't like where you're at? You can be somewhere else, like the beach. Or even Paris, France.
Uh-huh.
Or even outer space. Ooh, I'm in outer space. You can be anywhere you want, and you can be anyone you want. With filters, no one has to know if you're sad or angry or embarrassed or awkward. Filters can always make you the best version of you.
Yeah, that's a good story, Kellen.
I don't think he's gotten to the story yet.
It's not really a story, actually. It's more of a verse. Check it out. God is faithful and fair. If we confess our sins, he will forgive our sins. He will forgive every wrong thing we have done. He will make us pure. You see, God wants to see when we're sad or angry or embarrassed or awkward, and he wants us to tell him when we've broken the rules or made a choice we don't feel good about. He wants us to come to him unfiltered. Even though it may be hard to be yourself with others, you can always be yourself with God because he loves you and he will forgive you of every wrong thing you've ever done. And that, my friends, puts a smile on my face.
Me two.
Me three.
Well, I'll see you when I see you guys.
Bye, Kellen.
You know, I think I probably do hide my real self sometimes, but I've learned I don't have to do that with God.
Oh, yeah, and I've learned only text LOL to someone if I've literally laughed out loud. Otherwise, it'd be like lying, right?
I guess.
I have also learned something.
What have you learned, Phantom?
This.
What? Silvio?
Yes, John. I know. I left no clue.
What an unexpected reveal.
Ah, yes. Reveal the question.
What do you talk to God about?
Yeah, I mean, for me, it could be anything. I tell God about my day.
My hopes and dreams.
My greatest fears, like antique furniture.
And now, I must leave you.
Wait! Are you still gonna clean here?
Oh, consider this my 2 weeks' notice.
Is that the only way he can leave a room?
What do you talk to God about? Talk about it with each other.
Or just talk about it with God.
Oh, even better.
And we'll see you next time on The So-and-So Show.
Bye. That was perfect timing. Awesome. That was perfect timing.
far to the side, then you're gonna get stuck. It might feel like a little lie, but it's gonna catch up. Do what you say you're gonna do, you'll be on your way up. Instead, you're on your way up. You'll be living straight up. Maybe you've got a crew, and you said we're gonna do the good things that good friends do. And everybody's still a good friend who sticks like glue. 'Cause everybody did what they said and everybody was true. Maybe you wanted it but you didn't take it. Maybe you promised and then you didn't break it. Maybe you learned the words so you didn't fake it. And now everybody knows. But if instead you move straight ahead, keeping your promises, you'll be living straight up. If you move too far to the side, then you're gonna get stuck. It might feel like a little lie, but it's gonna catch up. Do what you say you're gonna do, you'll be on your way up. Instead, you're on your way up. You'll be living straight up. If you move too far to the side, then you're gonna get stuck. It might feel like a little lie, but it's gonna catch up. Do what you say you're gonna do, you'll be on your way up. Said you're on your way up. You can choose to be true, not just to everybody else, but true to you. You can choose to be true, not just to everybody else, but true to you. True to you.